Hello everybody and welcome back to Screen Stars. I'm here today to give you a brief review on the first episode of the brand new Twilight Zone TV show that is streaming now. This is obviously an iconic TV show that is now getting its revival, and it got headlines this because I feel like it's been fronted by Jordan Peele, the very talented Jordan Peele from Get Out fame and the recent Us. And I think the timing of this being streamed now with the success of Us is very, very clever on their part. Certainly from the first episode, and I've looked at the write-up for the second episode, Jordan Peele's the co-writer. So I don't know if it's for all the episodes, but certainly the first two is one of the co-writers as well. As well as, of course, the narrator of each episode. Now, the first episode is called The Comedian. And I suppose makes sense really with Jordan Peele's background, comedic background. However, while I don't think this was an appallingly bad episode or anything like that, I thought it was a very, very weak start to a brand new series, and it didn't make an awful lot of sense in that regard, because at the end of this episode they show you what's coming up on the season on Twilight Zone, and then they show clips of some of the other episodes that are coming, and some of them looked considerably better than this episode. However, what is this episode about? And I'll only talk briefly about it. It stars, and I'm probably going to butcher this name, but I shall try, Kumail Nanjiani, who plays Samir, who is a struggling comedian, who's just not very funny, basically. And he is visited by a legendary comedian, played by Tracy Morgan, who gives him a piece of advice and tells him he needs to bring a bit more of his personal life into his act to get laughs. However, it comes at a cost. Samir initially he's just pleased to meet his idol, and then he decides to take his advice. However, it delivers some unexpected results as people close to him, or people he knows, end up disappearing as a result. Right, and that's all I want to say on this episode, because I don't want to spoil it, but like I've said, I don't think this is a particularly strong episode. Certainly, for an opening of a brand new TV show, it's a bit of an odd choice, in my opinion. I thought the idea itself is very, very clever. However, what I struggled with this episode was, even when he wasn't being funny, he was clearly not funny, but even when he was being funny and the audience was reacting to him, to me, what he was saying wasn't funny. So it felt false. Do you know what I mean? Sometimes when you watch a stand-up comedian, they're undeniably funny, and you roll with it, and it's very, very funny, and they're genuinely funny. The gags that they say, this guy Samir, the comedy that was getting the gags, didn't deserve the laughs they were getting, in my opinion, because they weren't overly funny. And that was it, really. It was just a whole episode of him, you know, picking fights to a certain degree of people he didn't like. I just didn't get it. Clever idea, reasonably poorly executed, but I thought Kumail Nanjiani did a great job as the comedian. I kind of related to him. I thought he was, you know, a reasonably interesting character, but for the life of me, I don't understand why this was chosen as the first episode of the new series. And like I say, you get Jordan Peele as the narrator. You see him briefly at the beginning of the episode and a little bit of narration at the beginning and at the end, and that's about it. And that might be the anchor or the pull that pulls people in, Jordan Peele. It's certainly, I think, why he has been chosen, because he's the big thing in horror right now. And Us being so successful at the minute, it's going to draw an audience to this. But I think they need to pick up the quality, certainly. There's another one that's available to watch now, a Terror at 30,000 Feet or something, which I'm going to give that a go. Whether I'm going to review it or not, I don't know. But for this episode, I think it's a bit disappointing. I'm giving it a 6 out of 10. I just didn't find it creepy, weird, scary, all them things you expect from a Twilight Zone episode. It wasn't really one of them, but it was an interesting idea. So yeah, I'll probably give another couple of episodes a chance, and if it's not really working for me, I'll probably give up at that point. So Thank you very much for watching, everybody. I'll see you next time on Screen Stars.